Hello and welcome to Rekombu. My name is Peter Phelps and today I'm going to be unboxing the Huawei P50 Pocket. Now this little device's design is just as cute as its name. It's a tiny foldable clamshell, so I can't wait to get it out of the box.
Cool.
Okay. These are all rolling. Yeah? Good to go?
Yeah, rolling. Literally.
Okay. Okay, so let's get it out of the box. Now, in case you didn't need any reminder, this product is a foldable phone with a flexible screen, which is probably why you're interested in it in the first place. Here's the device itself. Of course, we're going to get back to that in just a minute. Inside the box here, what have we got? We've got the SIM card's key right there. If we tip out this box, we've got clear plastic case for the phone with that all important hinge in the middle. And here we've got the charger, of course, and the USB-C cable. But let's get back to the main event, and that is, of course, the phone itself. Here's the device in all its glory. It's got a slightly dimpled rear cover, which catches the light quite nicely. This is the white edition. You can also get it in black or gold. And if you want to see that hinge in action, there it is. Okay, so when it's unfolded like this, the dimensions are 170 by 75.5 by 7.2 millimeters. So that's just quite a bit longer than a normal smartphone screen, as you can probably see right now. And when it's folded up like so, then the depth here is 15.5 millimeters. It weighs 190 grams, which is pretty much par for the course for a normal smartphone. It's not particularly weightier, despite its interesting design. Now, the camera module, as you can see here, it looks quite impressive. It's composed of three different cameras in total. One's a 40 megapixel true chroma, one's a 13 megapixel ultra wide, and then there's a 32 megapixel ultra spectrum camera. Now on the front, we've got a 10.7 megapixel ultra wide just here, and that can come in quite handy because you can sit something up like that to take a picture. Gives you a different format to play with there. Now the screen here, that's just turning on, that measures 6.9 inches, so pretty big. It's an OLED display. We've got 120 hertz refresh rate, which should mean it's pretty smooth to scroll along, and there's a 300 hertz touch sampling rate. Resolution is 2700 by 1228 pixels, and it supports over 1 billion colors, so it should have great contrast. And as we'll see when we get it up and running. Now in terms of performance, we've got a Snapdragon 888 4G processor. That's 4G, not 5G. There are no 5G Huawei phones, unfortunately. And it's got a 4000 mAh battery that supports 40 watt fast charging. Now the software is EMUI, Huawei's own EMUI 12 software. And unfortunately it won't be able to support Google apps or services, as you probably know about Huawei. And that's a big miss, really. It's a bit of a shame in the West because it's hard to recommend a phone that doesn't have those services on board. And that said, the price as well might put you off. It's got a euro price of 1,299 euros, which is pretty pricey. And that translates roughly into pounds of about 1,080 pounds. Now, while we have said that it will be available in specific markets in Asia Pacific, Middle East and Africa, Europe and Latin America, but we're yet to know exactly which countries it will launch in. Okay, so that was the Huawei P50 Pocket. Now, while its design still comes across as very innovative and different to all the other things you'll see on the smartphone market, there are a few drawbacks that might stop it from being a real runaway success. Now, those include the price, the lack of 5G connectivity, the lack of Google mobile apps and services. Without those things, it might seem like a bit of a novelty, but nonetheless, it's a fun one to play around with. Thanks very much for watching. Don't forget to let us know what you thought in the comments and subscribe for more video content from Rekombu.